Alright guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new, my name is Bobby. Guys, today I want to talk about changing your diet and experiencing certain dietary formats. Switching from veganism to carnivore, going onto a juice fast, fruit fast, experimenting with bodybuilding diets and whatnot. Guys, I've done all of those things and I've been blamed because of it. People will tell me, you failed on veganism because you've been flip-flopping around. But let's be honest, guys, there must be a need for it, right? There must be a reason why people experiment with certain diet forms. And for me, that was, of course, not different. I experienced severe issues with the vegan diet before I decided to try out something else. Another regimen, which in turn worked out perfectly fine for me. But now, as a carnivore, right? Or at least people want to classify me as a carnivore. What happens if that diet form does not work for me? What will happen then? Guys, normal people don't eat the same thing every single day, right? There's some people that eat at a sushi buffet one day, and then the other, they find themselves in McDonald's. That doesn't mean that they are a pescatarian the one day and junk food addicts the other. They're just people, and they like to eat different things. In the vegan dogma, you cannot experiment with other regimes. But I propose a question to you. Shouldn't that be saluted? Shouldn't we be saluted to be so brave to experiment on our own bodies, right? This is what people in the diet world truly do. They're pioneers in that sense. They experiment on their own bodies. Brave pioneers that are about to find out what works for them. True, free, open-minded thinkers that are not to be constrained by any dietary dogma. I salute that. I think that is great. So, when I was 12 years old, I started out with intermittent fasting. Yes, this is how it all started. I was a chubby fat kid and I found a ladies' magazine at a friend's house of my mom's. I found the secret to weight loss. This is what the cover said. The secret was to not eat after 8 p.m. I applied it straight away. I jumped in it head first and I started intermittent fasting. With 14, I lost all the weight. 2 years of radical dieting, if you will. But then I was kind of skinny. 14, 15, 16, puberty hit in and I became a skinny teenager. Now I got interested in bodybuilding and I started with the rice and chicken regimen. That suited me perfectly fine. I made tremendous gains. From 16 to 19, I packed on 30 kilograms of muscle mass. Craziness. I went up from 60 kilograms to 90. Jacked. Yeah, I loved bodybuilding. Those were those days. After a while, I started experimenting with psychedelic drugs and whatnot, induced through a terminal illness that I was battling. And I experimented with pescatarianism, vegetarianism, veganism. And all of those things were valuable learning lessons. Those experiences will always be in my heart. Those experiences shaped the man that I am today. I'm forever grateful. But there were experiences, learning lessons that I transcended now. And therefore, guys, to wrap this up somehow, it is about experiences that shape you, that form you, and so you can have valuable understanding of certain diet forms and certain practices in this life that will lead you towards more understanding about yourself. Simple. This is what it is about, or this is what it should be about. You become a free thinker. Nobody can tell you anything anymore. You will learn it for yourself. You have to learn it and comprehend it for yourself. This is what I had to do. People like to blame Casey from Vegetable Police. He's been flip-flopping around. But guys, you didn't spend time in his shoes. You do not know how this guy truly feels. Thank God you do not have those gut issues. This man has been struggling for over 10 years. And therefore, he did what he had to do in order to fix his issues. I salute him for that. The same goes for me. People like to point out that I was muscular as a vegan and that I look good. Yeah, great, but I had diarrhea for 8 months, looking good. What does that tell you? You're not in my shoes. You have no idea how I felt. You weren't depressed. I was. You didn't have diarrhea. I had. You didn't have excruciating belly pains and teeth rotting out of your face. I did. Right? But you can sit comfortably in front of your computer, point the finger and say, yeah, but you just look the same. I saw the Instagram pictures. So what? It doesn't prove shit. I felt terrible. Therefore, you can read study after study after study. You will always find a study that will support your claim. And then guess what? You will find a study that can debunk the exact same claim. In the end, you will have to try it out for yourself. So nobody can tell you anything. Do you understand this? Once you truly mastered a craft, and I say it takes about 3 years to become proficient at it, not to master it, but to become good at a craft, then from there out on, you can truly know for yourself. Guys, I've been vegan for 4 years. I gave it a fair effort. I tried everything within that realm. It didn't work for me. Back in those days, I wished it would, but it didn't. Now looking back, I'm happy that it didn't, because I'm so much more healthy and vibrant nowadays. But will my diet change again? Yeah, of course it will. Will I ever be identified as something again? No. And I want to make it clear in this video. I am not team carnivore. I do enjoy a carnivore diet. Yes. I do enjoy certain carbohydrates sometimes. Yes. But I am not identified with diet any longer. Let me tell you one more thing, guys. When I was a bodybuilder, round about from 19 to 21 years old, I was identified as a bodybuilder. Bobby the bodybuilder. That was it. Not as Bobby the rice and chicken eater. I had it with those diet labels. Food is here to fuel you. Food is here to serve you. Food is here to nourish your body. Not to become a religion, an identification. Guys, you will have to experiment on your own body. See what works for you and then live your life. Alright guys, and that's it for today's video. If you liked it, leave it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed already, please do so. And as always guys, much love and peace.